This Medical Minute sponsored by Avera.
Well, it is that time of year when more and more little ones are coming down with viruses, specifically RSV.
And every year, as it turns out, about 57,000 kids under the age of 5 end up hospitalized because of this virus.
And tonight's Avera Medical Minute, Tess Hedrick explains the signs and symptoms all you parents should look out for.
Jude is go with the flow, happy-go-lucky, that type of kid.
But just a few weeks ago, 8-month-old Jude Schumacher wasn't acting like himself and was wheezing.
It is really scary, especially when they're so little and you see them struggling. You know, it's you're just wondering what to do and whether to bring them in or not.
Jude was diagnosed with RSV, a common respiratory virus in infants and toddlers. A few days later, Mom Alicia says Jude's wheezing got worse and he started to act more lethargic.
The doctor really suggested that we go to the ER because he was concerned about his oxygen and him breathing too quickly.
With RSV, it seems like usually the first 3 to 5 days are the worst.
Pediatrician Dr. Sam Schimmel says dehydration and low oxygen levels are usually what lands little ones with RSV in the hospital.
And the signs of that would be lots of coughing, lots of real rapid labored breathing, and you know, mom's trying to nurse or give a bottle and they put it in their mouth because they're hungry and it comes out right away because they can't breathe and eat at the same time.
And when it comes to treating RSV, it's all symptomatic care.
But if there's wheezing or respiratory symptoms, kids in the hospital or sometimes in clinic, we may try some NEBS. Not all kids will need them, but some kids will benefit. Tylenol, Motrin, just to keep fevers down, to keep them more comfortable, make sure they keep plenty of fluids in to stay hydrated and let time take care of the rest of it.
Jude was in the hospital for just a day, so we felt really lucky that he didn't have to be in the hospital for a week, and really they just got him back to where he needed to be.
The tough part about RSV is that it's very contagious.
It's usually from runny nose and congestion, and they touch their runny nose and they touch everything, and the next kid comes along and reverses the process.
Dr. Schimmel-Fennig says don't wait until morning to take your child in.
But it's always better to check them out and reassure a family, hey, we're in good shape, keep doing what you're doing, or maybe try doing this instead. But if they're really sick, that's where they need to be, if they need to be admitted.
I think all parents kind of go back and forth, and you say to yourself, should I go in, shouldn't I go in, are they going to tell me it's viral, that type of thing.
Boop.
But you are your child's best advocate, and you know your child better than anybody. So if you're feeling like they're lethargic, not acting themselves, that type of thing, just go in, even if it's for your own peace of mind. That's why we're so happy we did, because he ended up hospitalized.
With your Avera Medical Minute, I'm Tess Hedrick, KSFY News.
He sure is cute. To help stop the spread of RSV, kids should cover their cough, wash their hands often, and avoid touching their face. For more information, call 1-877-ATAVERA or head to KSFY.com and click on Health.